Hello everyone, I'm correspondent Liu Hai from Xinhua News Agency. I'm now in Lingwu City in northwest China's Ningxia Hui Autonomous Region. The first ever high-speed railway in Ningxia, which connects the region with other parts of the country, is under construction. Now you can see that the 500-meter-long tracks have been laid. Track laying is one of the most important procedures during the construction. This is Mr. Yang Jiangshuai, engineer of the project office. He will tell us how do they lay the 500-meter-long track.
Yang, 技术员您好，您给我们介绍一下咱们这个500米长的这个钢轨是怎么铺设的？现在这个500米是长轨是通过T11这个平板车拉到现场，然后通过从那个前面有个推送车。通过推送车把这个钢轨先牵到牵出去，然后再通过牵引车往前面牵引，然后就可以经过大约15分钟的时间就可以把这个钢轨从那个牵引从那个平板车上落到那个钢那个城轨槽里边。
咱们这个一根钢轨大概有多重啊？然后铺设的话是需要多久？一天能铺一个什么样的进度？
钢轨的话，因为现在就是60千克每米的，500米的话大约是30吨重。每天我们现在每天就是1公里能每天能铺个3.5公里，也就是7对。要是从厂家直接就是拉到现场，然后就是在现场铺的，所以说，我们项目就是不用建那个铺轨基地了，也是比较省钱。然后就是因为这个牵引车的牵引速度快，每铺一对儿都是15分钟就可以把那个钢轨从那个 T11 的平板车上拉下来，然后就是铺的速度比较快嘛。
The engineer told me that they used a push and pull method to lay the track. This method is also applied for the first time in the ballasted rail in China. Both manual operation and mechanical manipulation are used in the laying procedure. Workers lay the ballasts and cross ties with machines first, then the track cart pulls the track in front, and a caterpillar vehicle pushes the track behind. A single track is 500 meters long and 30 tons weight. It takes about 15 minutes to lay a pair of tracks from the vehicle. And when they are laid on the cross ties, workers will go on the next procedures. They use tools to fix the screws and then use machines to tighten them. This approach has lots of advantages over the traditional ways, such as flexibility, efficiency, and speed. Moreover, track laying base is not necessary in the construction site.
过去用的就是25米的标准轨，现在用的都是500米的钢轨。因为500米的钢轨又没有接缝，到最后都要焊成那个，就是从500米焊成2公里的那个长轨条。这样的话可以提高那个乘客的舒适度，然后可以提高列车的速度。
He also told me that comparing with 25-meter-long tracks they used 2 decades before, the 500-meter-long track can effectively improve the speed of the train and the comfortability of the passengers.
Yinchuan to Xi'an high-speed railway, which links Yinchuan, capital of Ningxia, and Xi'an, capital of northwest China's Shaanxi province, has a total length of 618 kilometers, and it is one of the key projects included in China's mid- and long-term railway network scheme. The high-speed railway is scheduled to open in 2020. Once completed, the travel time between Yinchuan and Xi'an will be cut from 14 hours to 3 hours. With an investment of some $13 billion, the railway is expected to inject new vitality into the less developed region and also connect the region into the national high-speed railway network. The railway is also expected to bring more opportunities in terms of economic and social development to Ningxia, as well as its neighboring provinces and regions. Yinchuan to Xi'an high-speed railway is China's second ballasted rail track, newly constructed in recent years, and also the first one in northwest China, which is designed for bullet trains running at a speed of 250 kilometers per hour. The ballasted rail track is opposite of that is ballastless. Or let's say in an easy way, ballastless rail track means track with small stones in it. And the ballastless rail track has no small stones, but the concrete reinforced instead. Whether the track should be ballasted or ballastless depends on different conditions. Usually, if the rail track is designed for trains running over 300 kilometers per hour, it is ballastless track, as when the train runs at a very fast speed, it is likely to bring the small stones because of the huge airflow, and it is dangerous. Ballasted rail track has also something with the geographic circumstances, as it should take the climate, environment, as well as the maintenance into consideration.
Thank you.
It is very hot today. The temperature is 32 degrees centigrade. But the workers are still working very hard in the heat. They try their best to assure the project going on smoothly and safely as it is scheduled. Let me ask one of them about their work and wish. 您好，师傅。啊。请问一下，您怎么称呼？
我姓王。
您是从哪里来的呀？
甘肃。
甘肃。
啊、
甘肃人。
啊。
来这边修高铁来了多久了？
快3个月了。
您在工地上主要做些什么呢？
就是掰整布啊，架钢管啊，上扣钳，上刀灶。
每天工作多长时间呢？
就是10来个小时啊。
十来个小时，
啊、
累不累？
很赞，行了。
还可以、啊。
好。
您是参加咱们这个铁路建设也有些年了是吧？
10几年了。
干了10几年了。那去过很多地方。
就是啊。
去过哪些地方？
内蒙。甘肃、新疆、青海、山东、陕西这一带，河北。
那也是见证了咱们这个铁路事业发展。
还可以啊。
您谈一谈吧，有什么感想？
这就干个这个活吧，再别的活不干，就干个铁路就行了。
谢谢。The worker told me his name is Wang Fuji and he comes from Tianshui, northwest China's Gansu province. He has been here in the construction site for about 3 months, and he has been worked as a railway constructor for more than 10 years. In the last decade, he has been to many provinces such as Shandong province, Qinghai province, and Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. His main work is to lay the tracks and cross ties in the site. And I asked about his wish. He told me that he wished the Yinchuan to Xi'an high-speed railway will complete as early as possible. Over the past decade, high-speed railways have developed rapidly in China, the speed, convenience, and comfortability of which have become quite appealing to passengers from all over the world. China currently has the world's largest high-speed rail network, about a third of which has been designed to run at a speed of 350 kilometers per hour.The railway network in the country hit 127,000 kilometers in length at the end of 2017, including 25,000 kilometers of high-speed railway. China also helps building railway lines in foreign countries such as Zambia and Kenya. More railway lines are built with all made-in-China parts.China is developing new bullet trains with a speed up to 400 kilometers per hour and is also researching the next generation magnetic levitation train with a top speed of 600 kilometers per hour. Automatic and unmanned drive technology will be used in the future.We know from the project office that the Yinchuan to Wuzhong section of the Yinchuan to Xi'an high-speed railway will be put into use at the end of this year, 2 years in advance of the whole line being in operation by 2020. And we are also looking forward to seeing more great changes taking place and making our lives better and better. That's all for today's program. Thanks for watching. See you next time.